Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about why you should use views instead of table. You have a Power BI reports or dashboards that is pointing to a database. When it is connected to database, I would like to recommend like you should not point to tables. Instead of that, you need to point to views. Pointing to views or reading from the views has a lot of advantages over tables, and it is the industry recommendation as well. Let us check it out, one such an example that happened in real time. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's try to understand the views, what is its purpose. If you don't know what is views, just go and check it in my SQL Server playlist where I have explained what is the views. So views basically provides abstraction over tables, like it hides what table you are picking it from and the schemas that we are taking it from. You can create another schema and that will point to another table as well. So it gives abstraction layer, and moreover, once you are doing importing a table, after that you perform joins in Power Query. Instead of that, you can use views to join or do a lot of complex operations when your data source is a database, right? So you can effectively use those things. Your joins in views is very simple, and your load to the Power BI or Power Query is much reduced. Views can hide the database specific objects from user. So as I said before, it's more or less similar. So you maybe like those who are in reporting, they should not aware what kind of table or what is the exact table. Then you should use views. Then views can help you with easy management of different system failures. Basically, like you create a view and is there any issues to the table, all the dependent system will fail. But when you have views, you can try to manage it. This is the purpose I created this video. I'll try to explain one such a scenario. Like if it is a table, you cannot do much, but when it comes to a view, you have some little bit of control so that your higher environments or dependent environments from the views or tables won't get affected. I mean, when you use table, it will affect, but when you use views, you can handle it in such a way. Let us try to check it out in this video. So one of the example I want to highlight is like this particular dashboard that most of them familiar with who are following this channel, and it is now connected to a database. Let me go to the database now. I mean, show the connection string. This is the advanced editor and this is the data source name, that is the database name. I'm picking it from demo sales data. This is the data. Now, as soon as I'm pointing this one to a table now, and it is published and it's ongoing report, when there is some changes happening, like because there are some companies or most of the companies, the database team is separate and the reporting team is separate. Whatever data changes happening in the database, it's not properly communicated, it gives you a failure. Assume like this particular column, right, or a type is deleted or they renamed it. Let us go and do it like rename, right? Or a type, I will rename it to something else. Order, or it can be only the type. Let's do like that. So once you point it to a table and it is up and running, now once you click on refresh, right? So the next refresh, as soon as you change it, this report will always be in issue mode or in error on yes mode. So unless the database team is responded, and if this report is very crucial, you cannot fix this report once you have a table. Assume you have a table or view here. Now I'm creating a view. right? Create, view, view, demo, sales. This is typically you have a view, you can create it. Now there is no order type, but whereas you have called type, right? This is the column name. Now I've created this view, and if I have pointed out this particular view earlier, right, then what I might have done is, like, instead of order type earlier, it might be order type over here. Now I can put type over here and keep the alias, right? This is the way you can handle it. Now I've created the view using the new column and give the alias name as order type. So once you query it, once you query this particular table, you will get the result as type. But when you query this view now, right, let me alter this view. Once you query this, you will get the result as order type name, whatever you want, you whatever pre-existing. So I will go and change. So assumption, like, if you have used this particular report before using only the view, right, there won't be any issues. So I'm not doing this now, assuming we already have this particular report. Let me show. I will create some other issue and we will try to wrap it up. Now what I am doing is, like, give me a minute. Let me go here, then go to refresh all, and where it is, Naga store, and this is the sales. Hold on, I hope I've created this in the master by mistake. Drop view, I should not create it in the master, I have to create it here. Create view. Okay, now I've created this view here in the Naga store, and I have this report over here. Now I'm pressing OK, then press refresh all. Now this data will be appearing here. Now earlier in the table I cannot do much because this is already deployed. Now I have a view connected, right? So once you have an issue in when you connect it to the view, changing in the view will solve the issue. That is what I want to make. So this is how I recently cleared out one of the issue that is very critical, that this particular report is going for production, and there was some changes in the database. Now using the views, one because that is the recommended, we always go by views to create the report, so that any changes that we can quickly handle it, we can do it immediately. I hope you like this video. Press the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.